What's good, creators? Welcome back to Monzo Media. Today we're going to learn about this. This is called speed ramping, and I'm going to show you how to do it within DaVinci Resolve. So on the timeline, you're going to see my clip here. And the first thing I want to do is find the point where I want the speed to change. So the beginning of this clip is just going to be played at 100%. I'm going to look for the point where she looks up. This is where I want it to speed up. Now to start the speed ramping, you can do two things. You can press Control R and you're going to see your clip change with these blue arrows. And alternatively, you can right click and look for Retime Controls. See here, it says the shortcut key is Control R. Now you're going to notice this little drop down, and this is where you can add the speed points where you want the speed to change, and you can also change the speed here as well. So for now, I'm just going to click on Add Speed Point, and you're going to see at this point, now it adds this little marker here. So what I'm going to do is change this to about 400% to get it to speed up. And then the other thing I want to do is slow it down when she looks up. So this point where she looks up, I'm going to again click this little arrow and add another speed point. And now you see on this side of the clip gives you that drop down. So I'm going to change this to 25%. Then the next thing I want to do is find the place where I want the slow motion to stop and go back to regular time. So I'm going to add another speed point here and then change this section to 100%. Now before you preview this, chances are you're probably going to have to render the clip. So if you haven't enabled that, you can go into your playback area here and go under Render Cache and use Smart or User. Basically, Smart will do it automatically for you. User, you can do it manually. Now you're going to see the blue line here. That basically just means that the clip is rendering so that you could play it and it's actually going to look smoother when you play it back. So let's do a little preview of how it looks here now. Here it is at 100% speed, speeds up to 400%, and then we have our slow motion part there, and then back to regular. So all in all, I'm pretty happy with the results here, but in case you want to smoothen out those transitions between the speeds, what you can do is right click onto your clip and find Retime Curve. Now you're going to see this little section here. I'm going to adjust this a little bit. And then you're going to see the points where the speed changes. And what you want to do is click on this drop down here and go all the way to the bottom and uncheck Retime Frame and change it to Retime Speed. Now you're going to see these two points and how abrupt that transition is. So if we preview it again, it's very abrupt. It just gets right in there, right? So what you can do is when you click on these little dots here, click on this icon, and this will give you the little handles. You can smoothen out that transition. So I'm going to do the same thing here for this one. And basically, if you want to smoothen that transition, you can pull on these little points here and smoothen that out. So now we have more of a gentler curve there. So if we preview this, so it's a lot smoother. It's not as abrupt as it was prior. So let's try that again. And there you go. One other thing to mention is that you can pull any of these speed points to adjust it to different points of the timeline. So let's say I wanted to change that there. or if I wanted to bring this over there that way. But keep in mind that when you do that, see the percentage here? That means that you're now adjusting the speed of this particular clip in this area here. So now it's slowed down only at 32%, before it was 25%. But this is a good way to make those really slight and fine adjustments. And it's really just that simple. One of the things I really love about DaVinci Resolve is, you know, little features like this makes it super easy to do. And even if you're beginning with DaVinci Resolve, this isn't a very hard technique to use. The only thing is that, again, you got to use this very tastefully. Typically, I wouldn't do this type of speed ramping for this clip. The slowdown part, I would do that for this particular clip, but I wouldn't necessarily do any speed ramping for this clip itself. But stay tuned for future videos as we'll get deeper into speed ramping and working with retime controls and that sort of thing, because there's a lot of things you can do. Just get out there, hit record, create, and I'll see you when I see you.